What's up, you guys? It's your girl, Unique the Iconic. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. I'm so excited about this video because I just love how this look came out. Like, you guys, I was struggling with this a little bit. Like, oh my gosh, like, it just came out so fucking pretty. But this look was inspired by Summer Walker. She had this same exact look for one of her shows, and I just saw it. I was like, oh my gosh, this look is just so beautiful. Like, it's so fucking cute, but so simple. Like, it was just so cute, and I've never seen anyone with that look before. I was supposed to do this back in, like, last year, like, end of November, I think, or, like, a December. But I don't know what happened. I don't know. But I ran across the screenshot that I took of her look on my phone. And I was like, oh, snap. I got to do this look. I got to do this look before I forget about it or I don't want to do it anymore. But yeah, you guys, I really love the way it came out. But if y'all want to know how I got this look, please stay tuned and watch the rest of this video. Okay, you guys, so the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going what the f***? No, that's not what I say. Okay, so you guys, scratch that. Okay, you guys, so the first thing I'm going to do is grab the Elmer's glue in order to get this eyebrow right here. Now, when I tell you, this eyebrow took some work. Like, I mean, you can see my hair a little bit, but you can't really tell. I don't know how drag queens do it. I give it to them, but I already put, like, one layer on when I first started on this one, but I'm going to put just another one on, like, just in case, because, y'all, like, these eyebrows was not laying down like how I really wanted them to. I don't know why. I think that's all I need. I just needed those two coats. And I'm just going to brush it kind of, like, straight up. Now I'm taking the Beauty Bakery. This is their, what is it? It's right here, y'all. It's tripping. This is the Better Not Bitter Flower Setting Powder. This is in the shade Cassava. I'm just taking this little mini beauty blender right here. And I'm just going to, like, set right there. Set wherever I put that glue so it does not move. Now I'm taking the Absolute New York. I'm just taking a regular concealer that matches my skin tone. And this is in the shade, oh wait, where'd it go? Ooh. Baby, where did you go? We're just gonna use 07. I mean, it's gonna come out the same regardless. Hopefully it comes out the same because this bit was giving me problems. Now, I want to keep the concealer at a minimum. Just cover it wherever we put glue. Now, I'm just going to blend it out because, like I said, you got to blend this out fast. This is a fast-drying concealer, you guys. And then not only that, like, the setting powder is kind of, like, setting it, too, at the same time. You can still see a little bit of my hairs. So, you guys, I'm going to be doing a few voiceovers in this video only because I'm kind of upset that the video, I actually didn't get to capture the full face, only just the eye part, which really is the most important. But let's go ahead and continue. I'm just going to go ahead and set that concealer that I put on the eyebrow just to make sure it doesn't move anywhere. And then I'm just going to fill my eyebrow in like how I normally would if I was doing a regular face. I'm just going to stop where there's no more eyebrow hairs that are showing, and then I'm just going to kind of create a sharp line so that there's a space between the patch and the other piece of the eyebrow. Okay, so after that's done, now I'm going to go in with the same concealer, but I'm going to use a shade lighter. This is the 05.
So I'm going to go ahead and use that lighter concealer just to conceal my eyebrows the same way I would, like I said, if I was doing a regular face. I am going to stop at the patch line just to be careful not to kind of move my eyebrows that's already laying down. And once I do that, I'm going to go ahead and grab my flat concealer brush. I'm going to use a flat concealer brush just to kind of put some of that same concealer shade over that patch to make it look more defined and just more realistic.
On to the next thing. So I'm gonna go use the P. Louise base. This is the Rumor base in the shade 4. I'm going to put a lot of this on my eyelid, all the way up a little bit to the brow, only because I really, really want the colors to show, like the pigmentation and everything like that. Because, you know, this makeup look, the colors are very, very bright, and I really want them to show when I apply the eyeshadow. Okay, so I'm gonna be taking the Morphe 35B palette. I seen that in the picture she had kind of like that purple bluish type of eyeshadow going on at the top, so I really still want to keep that same look. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this Real Techniques. This is a domed shadow brush, and I'm gonna take over here in the 35B, I'm gonna take this this eyeshadow and this one too. This one and this one.
Now you guys, with that dome brush, I'm going to definitely pack on a lot of color. The only reason I'm doing that is because I really, really want the pigments and the color to show on the base. So I am grabbing a lot of product, and I just have to be very careful with it just to make sure it doesn't go over the place. Because like I said, you guys, this is a cut crease. It's a very detailed eye, and we just don't want to have the shadow everywhere, being that it is a very bright color. So I'm going to go ahead and buff out that line at the top, and then I'm going to use a clean blending brush, and I'm going to kind of use some of that shadow to blend out the line some more so it's not as harsh. Now I'm going to take the P. Louise Rumor base in the shade 0. It's a pure white base. I'm going to use this base just to cut crease my eye. Now I am going to bit over my eyelid because I do have bigger eyes in summer, but I really want the colors to show. So with this, I'm going to be very, very careful. I definitely took my time with this because this cut crease was very, very detailed, and I wanted it to be exactly like how hers was. So just take your time, you guys, and just be kind of careful with it because you don't want to mess this up.
So now I'm going to go in with the BH Cosmetics Take Me to Brazil. This is definitely an OG palette, you guys, when it comes to colors. Like, oh my gosh. So now I'm going to go and take this shade right here.
Now with the shadow, you guys, I definitely did spray my brush with like any kind of spray just to be able to get it wet, and then I'm definitely packing on a lot of color just to be able to get all of the shadow onto as much base as possible so that the colors can show, and just so it won't be any creasing within the shadow. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of clean up around that cut crease line just to make sure everything's all smooth. After that, you definitely want to just clean up around it to make sure you get any excess and everything and all that. But other than that, you guys, I'm so sad that I did not get to record the face. I cannot believe that like my camera was just not recording it. Like, oh my gosh. But I'll definitely leave like a link to one of my recent videos that shows exactly how I did my face for this video. But thank you all so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe, you guys. I definitely feel like I did my thing on this one. If you think so, please let me know in the comments. But other than that, you guys, thank y'all so much for watching once again.